don't be afraid of it. It has to do with driving the opponent piece in the positions that we know to execute a combination. You see, a combination is not something that it is born in the air. It's something you prepare and you execute. It's not luck that you have some kind of combination at your disposal and you can easily make it. You have to work on it, and you hope for the best. You hope that you do it well, and your opponent will not have time to fight against it or simply overlook it. So, this is one of the basic things to learn, and I will show you the main position to start. And this is the position which we can start. Yeah. In a lot of students over the years, I asked them about this position, and I asked them, what exactly you think? It's not important to answer it. Really, it is not important, believe me. Because maybe you feel good when you solve something. But my main question is, will you solve it when it comes to the game? So there is only one way to do that, to learn it first. We should not be anxious to answer immediately that, yes, yes, I found the combination, and so on. No, this is what we call mechanism in tactics. What is a mechanism? It's not, again, we don't have nothing to do with cars, the machine, the mechanical parts, but it's a kind of how we drive the open-end piece to squares that we like. Now, what is the idea of black? The idea of black, of course, is to take back this pawn on g7 and try to exchange queens. Then the resulting ending, let's say rook against rook with the g pawn for white, it is not winning for him. Well, it's a draw. Position.
I can't see the position.
Sorry?
We can't see the position, the board.
You cannot see the position of the board, but I'm sharing my screen. Could you take it a little bit, Marlon?
Coach, you have to new share and then click on the board. Because right now what we're seeing is your chess base.
A new share.
Yeah, new share and then click the sharing of the board.
Okay. So every time I see a new game, I must put share again?
Yes, coach.
Yeah.
Yes, now okay. I can see.
Now you see, I think. Yeah, everybody see?
Yes, we can see it now.
Good. Marlon, if you don't see it next time, please tell me because we have to be sure.
This position
I'll try to repeat again a little bit. Yes?
This position is for white or black?
Well, any position is good to do it with both colors who is playing. If black is to play, let's say, he will play queen take g7.
Hello. And
he will exchange probably queens or not, doesn't matter. But only with one pawn, very difficult to win this position. I don't think that white can win. So, let's see when the move is for white.
Rook f8.
A8, just a moment. I don't want you to be quick. I want you to learn. To learn how is the mechanism, how it's working, because this is the most simple position. We'll go to more complicated, so you have to understand how it works. This is a tactical subject which is called the driving we drive the opponent piece. So the idea is, of course, to play rook f8, very nice. Black has to take the rook. Well, doesn't seem anything really. But then the second move is more important. Queen goes to a7. This is the basic idea. Because both black pieces are drived to the squares we want. And after, okay, you cannot play something like this. I make or either this, I win the black win, or either that, check, both of them are winning. It's not the problem. So take it, and now promotion to knight. The knight wins the queen, and then he wins the game because there is a pawn extra on g2. So the most funny thing is that the combination starting by white giving up the two pieces, f1 and the rook and the queen on g6, he promotes to a knight, which creates a fork, and then things are easy. Now, what happened to this? Why we have a combination which we can categorize according to certain factors? You see, all combination, they can be categorized. I mean, you put them in files and say, this is like this, this is driving, this is pin, this is fork, this is like this. So you can learn them. So first of all, the factor is, first one, we have a knight presence promotion which delivers the final blow. Okay? Second, the opponent queens is drawn to the ideal square. The queen was already here on d7, which is ideal square for us. And now our queen or other piece, he makes a little bit of a kind of sacrifice, because this is not really sacrifice. This is a combination. There is a big difference between combination and sacrifice. Sacrifice is when we don't know the result. We give something and we hope for the best. So I hear many people say, I sacrificed my queen and I made in two moves. This is not a sacrifice. This is the start of a combination. Sacrifice, the result is unknown. So we have three main things to remember.
Coach, the pieces are not moving.
Sorry?
The pieces are not moving.
Yes, I'm not moving the pieces because I'm not moving them. It's very simple, because we will not work only by moving the pieces. Moving the pieces, everybody can do. You will become better players when you know how to move the pieces. This is the main idea. Don't try all the time to move the pieces. Move your brain. This is more important. Pieces will follow you, what you said. This position comes from 250 years, more. 200 about 33 years, 83 years actually. Oh, very, very old. But we see that the combination, the tactical plays of the combination have not changed during the centuries. If the combination happens today, and it happens also about 300 years ago, so you understand that the combination can be learned. And of course, your brain now immediately recognizes the solution, which is very easy, of course. Right? There are extra pawns here, but the main thing you understand immediately, because already your brain takes it as a photo inside and stays. This is very important. So that's how good players are playing, let's say, very quick blitz and very good, because they have the photos inside. It's like a hard disk, takes photos. Your eyes take the photos, and the hard disk here in your brain makes them forever. So, of course, the rook goes to f8, and then the queen comes, and the knight comes, and the stuff now it is. That was also very simple. But simplicity is very important. Chess is not a difficult game. But you have to know how. So here we see world champion. Lasker, the second world champion against an unknown player, and then means unknown player, not named.
Actually. New share, coach, new share.
New share again.
Yep.
But you saw the previous game or not?
No, we're still on the diagram, example one.
So every game we should make new share. Okay. Simultaneous or a friendly unofficial match, we don't know. It was played in 1921. Lasker is white, the second world champion, and he has to do something about to defend on black threats. You see, the position again is not easy because white seems to have no check available, and there is a deadly check coming on e1. A very, very deadly check. So white has to act quickly. Do you remember the position? Do you remember the mechanism?
Yes.
Yes, coach.
It's easy, huh?
Yes.
Why it became easy? Because your brain already make a photo of it. It says, aha, this is it. I know it, I've seen it. So rook c8, of course, and queen a7. And the new knight who comes will kill everything. Easy stuff. Let's say easy, why not? It's not so that difficult, huh? Now another example, we'll see. As I told you before, but my screen was not working. This is the game where I was talking about, the game that was 300 years old. Again, your brain immediately tells you what is the solution. You already start to recognize the solution in 2 seconds. That's what I believe.
Coach, about the answer.
Perfect.
Yeah. So, you see, it doesn't matter that there are some extra, let's say, pieces, pawns inside. The basic combination we already learned, which goes, of course, rook f8, take it, check, and the knight comes and wins the game. Now, let's make it a little bit more complicated, if it's possible. Because position will not be all the time that easy. Huh? You have to understand this. So, okay, let's see this position. No. Not this position. But this position of the third world champion, José Raúl Capablanca from Cuba. Cuba.
The solution is rook f1, rook takes f1, and queen h2. The same.
Yes, you see how many positions I show you already between also good players, between world champions that they're playing this combination. You see, it's not something that happened one day in your life, because it happened to a lot of good players already. So if something is repeated all the time, it means that you can repeat it yourself. The solution is very easy. If we take it as black, even doesn't matter, there are some pounds inside. Of course, this check, and now this check. And the knight decides. Okay, until now we saw very nice things. I think it's, but let's see now a little bit more complicated. Many people who create studied problems, I mean, studied problems are not things that from happen in an actual game, but they're constructed, like we construct a house. They like to take something from actual games and turn it into a nice study. Here we have a study that it was made in 1921, about 100 years ago. Most of you don't know Leonid Kubel, but he was a very famous study composer, and he created many studies, I think over 1,500. So he used the idea, we just say here, you don't get it immediately. But okay, he started with the normal way. The normal way is I give a check. There are nothing to play. I mean, if you go with the king on a7, if you go with king on a7, then I will give you
rook at 6 and rook at 6.
Yes, and something here is made.
Okay.
Easy. So black play queen b8. Say okay. You cannot play now your rook here. I have a check. And you lose.
Yes.
But here can go here. That's it. So you see that white is a little problem. Okay, this check really kills. What to do?
Bishop takes.
If you go king c8, let's say you don't want the rook. I'll give you a check, and by this check, and by this one, it's a nice mate. Oops. The black king put it in a mating net, and he died. So after check, black must take the rook. Because every time we must consider two things. When you play a rook like this, you give a check and the opponent can take it. You cannot start saying, oh, my opponent will take it anyway. No, no, no. Just a moment. There is also the possibility that he will not take it.
Yes, I see it. This is king a6.
Bravo, king a6.
King a6. Queen
B7,
Queen
A8. He's threatening, yeah, but he's threatening Queen B7 mate. How to handle it?
If, Rook D7,
or Queen A8. And now the very, very nice move because...
Queen A8.
Yes, but I understand. It's the move. But what White did by now, he put every black piece in ideal square, driving. So now only the king has to go to ideal square. And he goes by this check, or he loses the queen. And now, after he takes, reminds me something like a video game, some dragons start eating. Tak, 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 you know? Something like this, you eat everything from your opponent. And black will lose now the game because the B pawn again will decide. So you see, this is a very nice study with the driving. First, we give the rook to drive the bishop, then we give the queen to drive the king, and then the knight makes all the dirty job. He starts killing every black piece. I think this is a very nice study. Anyehi. Who was Anyehi? Who knows? Nobody?
Sir?
Who was Alekhin? Do you know Alekhin who was? If you don't know, better is to say, no, I don't know. I'm always saying in my life, sorry, I don't know everything. But tell me, who was Alekhin? I want to know. So, Alekhin was the fourth world champion. First it was Steinitz. Second was Lasker, third was Capablanca. We saw a game of Lasker and Capablanca, and fourth was Alekhi. The game was played in 1937, very old time also. And okay, after this, sorry, yeah. It's a very, very complicated position where everything is hanging. The queen, the rook of white. There is a discovered check. Discovered check, when the knight goes away, the king will get in check. It's a very, very complicated position, it looks like. Here we have to study, and we have to think, and we have to calculate. There is nothing else. If you want to become good players, you have to learn to calculate. So check. It is normal, but it's doing anything. Okay, black says, I will play, if I play like this, I think this wins very easily. And now check. Main idea is when you take the knight, I will mate you. So black decide to cover the check with the rook. This is normal. And he's happy. We don't have time. Okay. I'll give a check. Discover check. If black has not too many options, he takes the rook. I take it. And that's all. So what? Is it a big deal? What do you think? What he can do. Yeah, he can take the rook, but this is wins or not?
He can take the rook on f6. Queen into f6.
The point is, take on f6, yes, but you must take with the queen. By check. Okay, so what? I take it, what you do? I'll start checking with my queen.
Rook g8.
Bravo, this is the main idea, driving. Now where the black king goes, doesn't matter. White takes the rook and takes the queen back. So he ends with a knight more. I think he must be happy, yeah? So you see that again, from this complicated position, where it was in the start, by moves working in the driving mechanism, what I'm explaining you this combination, in the end there is a knight more. Yes, in this game we had no promotion of the knight. I agree. So a promotion of the knight is not necessary as far as the knight do the job. And here black resigned because, okay, he was disappointed probably. Nobody wants to lose such a game. Now, Tigran Petrosyan. You know Tigran Petrosyan? Who was Tigran Petrosyan? Okay, generally I understand that for you chess is interesting because you see a lot of good things. You have your fun. I'm not against it. I like it. But on the other hand, it's nice to see the development of chess, because all these people that were talking, there were world champions. Petrosian Tigran was a world champion. There were not too many world champions in the world in the history of chess. In men, only 20 people made it to the highest title, this of the world champion. So they are not really big. I mean, there are other sports, they have 400 in history, 500, you understand, they're big numbers. And I don't say you have to know them, all of it, but some information, because they're playing some of them very interesting chess, is good. Tigran Petrosian was the ninth world champion. Number nine. So here he plays in with a strong grandmaster, Vladimir Simagin in Moscow. And he has to choose what to do. The most obvious move is, of course, to take the knight, the rook. Yeah? The most obvious, I take it. And I'm happy, yeah? I have a piece up. It looks like you should be happy. But here, Black had in his mind a mechanism of perpetual check. That perpetual check leads to a draw. This one is check. And okay, let's play like this. Check, check, and Black makes a draw, White cannot avoid the checks from three squares. This, this, and this. The Black win gives check on these squares, and White cannot cover his king. So the result is a draw. Obviously, if you find only this, which is the simple move, you are not happy.
The queen A8?
Yeah, just a moment before you say the move. Now, how we think during a game. We see that, okay, if I take the rook, my opponent has perpetual check. Okay, I'm not very happy, but if I don't have anything better, what to do? I will accept. There is no things that you can do like you want all the time. There are some things, simply you have to accept. But you can look. You can look if you have something better. So here, Petrosian found a much better idea. He gave a check. This is correct what you said. Now what to play? The king has two squares.
King G7, queen H8, check. King
yeah, if you go, no, mistake. You are in hurry. If you go like this, then I can take a check, and I can take this, and now I win. Because I will exchange, I will take everything by check. So the only move is king G7. Now you are telling me very quickly.
Happy.
You told me queen H8, which is a bad mistake. What will happen here? You remember what I told you before? When we give a piece, guys, when we give a piece, we must think of two things. My opponent takes the piece, and my opponent do not take the piece. Don't think all the time he will take it. What is he? Don't underestimate your opponent.
It should be fine.
Very important thing. So we have the driving. We have to force him. So we force him by driving the queen to a short square by check. Now Black has to take the bishop, but now this check. So Black has no options. He cannot play king g6, I take the queen simply. When you take my queen, oops, we have the combination, yeah? So you see, we must be careful how we'll make the combination. Because before what you said me, it's nice, but it's not forced. Because after this check, Black will tell you king g6, and what you done now? I'll tell you what you done. You destroyed your position. Because there are not much to do here, Now you have to take the rook and the perpetual. This is what white did not want to. So one move can destroy the game. Can destroy it because you are not accurate. We talk about the driving. We have to drive the queen, we have to drive the king. Be careful of this small detail which you missed. So, now we have a very funny position. Funny, it's not really funny, but what I mean, we have two world champions playing. We told that Petrosyan was the ninth world champion, and Spassky also was the 10th. He won against Petrosyan, and he took the title from him. But this was not so easy. You understand that winning a world champion against another world champion is not the most easy thing in the world. Okay, here, after some combinative ideas from Petrosyan, we reach a position where white has two exchanges down. Black has some threats, he's threatening the knight. And okay, also his knight here in a5 is out of play. You see, combinations, I told you, it doesn't come from born in the air. Here, black is losing because this knight on a5 is not working. If, for example, we put the knight here, centralized, very nice in the center, everything, black should be fine, more than fine. So everything is because his piece is very bad study. And again, I repeat, we see the combination played with world champions. This is very important to understand. Bishop, so, you understand the combination? You found it?
Bishop takes f7, if rook takes f7, queen h8, and if king takes h8, pawn.
Good. So, check. Can I go away?
Yes, but you will lose on this.
Yes, but how?
Queen h8 check.
Only move.
Knight f5.
I believe it's knight, yes. Yeah.
And queen c8.
And queen c8, it's the end of the day.
Checkmate.
Very nice. Your pieces are dancing. White pieces are dancing around the black king. So, only move, take it.
So then
queen h8.
Queen h8, yeah. Now it's forced. Take it, and here he resigned because we have extra piece. So we're very happy when we have an extra piece without counterplay, I repeat, because maybe we have extra piece, but if our opponent is pressing, he has good pieces, then the position might not be very clear. But if he has no counterplay, I'm sorry, there is nothing to hope. Now we see a game of a very attacking player, Rashid Nesmedino. I'm sure that you don't know all these names, but I can tell you, okay, I will ask you, do you know Mikhail Tal? Tal, you know him?
I know my
yes,
name
of Tal. Course.
I know him.
Yes, of course. Sure. Medvedev was winning against Tal 3-1. So you understand he was not a bad player, huh? Who says that I win against Tal 3-1? Not many people in the world. So here, we have a nice position where white has given his queen, but it's not very clear, let's say. So here white tries a nice combination, which has to do with driving. First of all, he drives the rook. The rook, what to do? He has to take. And now rook and queen, nice. Rook h8, check. Okay, what to do? Check. Bye-bye. Okay, let's say that black can fight, but this position he cannot fight too much because the ending is two pieces at the pawn. For a rook, he cannot hold. But I like the idea, driving. Let's see it again. Nesmedinov here, he gives the queen two, three moves before to reach this position, because he had already calculated that he can make the driving. So check, the rook goes to good square for us. Now the king has to go. Okay, if you don't go, I'll take your queen. And actually, when you play like this, first I will take this rook and then the queen, yeah?
Yes, now I pick it up. That's extra piece.
Extra piece, I'm very happy. But after check, mistake, both pieces were driving to the square we want, so white wins the ending. Don't expect that we'll make mate by force. It's not all the time so easy. So new position, you see it?
Yes.
Good. Now, let's see the position before we talk about the combination. White is on the defense. Black created an attack. It looks like that he created an attack. And he won exchange. Rook for bishop. But every time there are some small problems. Maybe if you exchange too many pieces, white can play like this. Like this, and
just rook of rook.
Don't go for the combination immediately. Try to understand the position. The combination is a part of the position. So we must understand what we want. Because the combination is working because we need to make it work.
Coach, rook F1.
Yes, I know, but I just told you something different. How to think. With me, you can learn how to think. You will not learn how to solve the combination. I don't care so much about this. This you will learn. Already you learned. It is in your brain, inside. It will not go away. You will see. You will remember it now, all your life. Automatically, your brain will tell you, play this. But my main idea is I want to teach you how to think, how to create these positions. Because I told you, you can play, you can win games by luck, you can win games because you are a better player. What do you want? What do you want? To win only the game or to become a better player? Tell me.
Better player.
Okay, how you become a better player? Just like this, because you want? Everybody wants. You become a better player because you start to recognize things. To know how to play the game, to create this position. Because a player like, let's say, Carlsen, and a player like you, they will find the same combination. It's not a problem. You will not find any different. But the question is, Carlsen will create it slowly, like a snake. He will kill you slowly, like a python. You are depending still in luck, and this we must change. So here, yes, rook f1, it's nice because, okay, black find it. And now the check, of course. Something else, if you take the pawn here, then this is mate. Otherwise, you can say that, okay, that will be a wrong combination. If there is domain. Okay, white here, of course, is on the attack. And, but he has a piece down for this attack. He has a piece down, and maybe his king also not very nice. Actually, if you look at the position, you would say, come on, looks very nice, very easy for black. He will consolidate a little bit. Okay, it's winning for black, but it's not like this. It's not winning because simply white is on the attack and he can create some nice stuff. First of all, okay, you tell me now. You see, now the combination is not easy. You have to create it. Anybody has an opinion?
So first, bishop captures.
Queen f6.
What?
Queen f6.
Queen f6. Okay, I have two options. Maybe bishop e5, maybe rook h7. You have to calculate both. It's not so easy, let's say.
Bishop h6.
Bishop f6 is not going. h6, you mean. I'll take it. Rook takes bishop and I'm very happy. And I want to tell you, you are a very nice boy for giving me your pieces. Okay, queen f6 is good. Now black has to make a move. He plays bishop e5. This is best move. Check. Only move, check. Now, what to play? Can you take the pawn? I mean, yes, you can take the pawn, but what happens if you take the pawn? Well, not much things to do. You must place your pieces in good squares to attack. So let's start with something like rook f1. So black has only one move. Yeah, there's only one move here, which maybe it is enough. What do you think? What happened, guys? You don't see winning in one move? Check. Only move. Check. Yes?
It's good.
Yes, coach.
He goes to c5. So, what did we do here? Not much. Okay. We have to find something else. Let's go back to this position. Not easy, guys, huh? I will tell you why it's not easy, why you see it a little bit difficult. Because the main thing in this position is to bring this rook, who is doing nothing, into play. I think that white here has a lot of good solutions, but don't be in a hurry. Let's play a move like this. this move attacks the knight, and he puts way for the other rook to come here, and all black pieces are having big problems where the knight will go. I see something on like this only, but now check. You see, I have two rooks on the attack and one queen. This is like a big force. What? You fell down or what? Now it's over because you will lose material. So, black decided here to play bishop g7. I think this is normal, yeah? I attack the queen. Okay, what is my problem? I think that black defended very well.
Sir, rook to e8.
I'll take it.
So then queen to g7.
So we're trying to make a movement like this. You know, so this is critical square. Drive for this square. Very good. So check. Okay, if you don't take it, you take the pawn. This is mate in one, no problem. So you have to take, drive the rook, drive the king. Oops, the knight. You see, combination is same. Rook up. You understand how to do it? So you see this combination, we see it after there are some other moves in between. It doesn't go so easily until we see now, become more complicated. And you have to expect these combinations during the game. Unfortunately, not easy. Your opponent don't want to lose. He's a bad boy. Okay. Judith Polgar against Anand. Famous game. And okay, it was not so nice for Anand because he lost this game. You understand that he was not very happy. And Judith Polgar was the strongest, it is the strongest woman in history. And one moment he was among the 10 best players in the world. Men or women, doesn't matter. But we don't have many examples like Judith Polgar, because there are three sisters. But Judith made it to the top 10. She was killing everybody. So here he has a better position against Anand, but it looks like Anand can defend. But she knows the combination. And immediately her brain is working for it. So he played the four. Why she played the four? Mainly to open this diagonal. So black has to take, he doesn't have any other thing. And now check. Well, here, as far as I know, Anand became red, because he understands that something bad is coming, and he resigned. Okay, why he resigned? Let's see. Only move is this. There is no other move. Now check. We open the diagonal. Okay, black has to make a move now. If you play your king on f7, I think it's quite easy stuff. I'm taking your queen, and I'm very, very happy. So maybe only move bishop f6. It seems like black is winning, huh? Double attack. I'm attacking your queen. I'm attacking your rook. Over. Looks like. But this is not the case. The driving. Where is the driving?
Rook at 7.
The driving is like this. You understand? Here is the critical. Rook 8-7? No. Why? Rook H7. If you play rook H7, I'll take it, and if you give a check, maybe I'll play something like this. Did you win?
Knight D7. Check.
Yes, and rook takes queen. Oops, you missed that, huh? Who is winning now? That's how you can miss the point if you are not. It's the second time I see you that you are playing, all of you, very quickly. You don't be accurate. I said we must drive. First queen takes f6.
Hi, Tommy.
Okay, he has to take. Now rook h7, because you put your rook on my eagle square. Now, whatever you do, you will end with a piece down. Take or no take, no problem, you will lose. You will be a piece down. Choose what you like. As we say, choose how you want to die. What is the difference? You will die anyway, he says here, white. Choose how you like. Take the rook, knight f6, knight d7, driving. Go with the king back, rook takes d7, I have a piece up. And this is a very nice combination, and we cannot underestimate it, because you understand that a very good grandmaster, world champion, like Anat, felt for it. Something is not good, huh? Okay, this game of two good players. Here, white has to find a solution. Okay, white wins with different moves, I think, because the black king very badly, but he chose the most, let's say, nice. Driving. Check. Oh. I'm sure black didn't like this check. Okay. He resigned. Goes after here. Check. Double attack. You would drive the queen, we drive the king, and the knight gives the solution. I think it's easy, yeah?
Yes, sir.
Well, easy looks like easy, but sometimes, you know, we miss it. A game between two girls, not so long time ago, 2012. Black is a better player, 300 something points more. And but white played a nice game, and here, as you see, he has given black white his queen for only two pieces, but also three pawns, very important. So black is really feeling not happy. What to do here? White lost here a very good chance. She saw the rook is hanging on b7. So she immediately moved the rook somewhere. But she forget about the driving. How is the driving? Okay, simple. After knight g5, black has some deadly threats. He's threatening knight take h7 mate. He's threatening knight d6 check, which black has to give the queen. It looks like over. But black would say, okay, what about if I take the rook? Then this is the deal, check. Now you have to take the bishop or play something else, I'm not sure. If you play like this, no. It's a very difficult position, you have to take it. And check. And white wins, he will take the queen, after he will take the rook. So after knight d6 checks, black take on f7, driving. First the queen goes to ideal square, Then the king goes to ideal square, and the knight forks both of them. And of course, white will win. White player didn't see that. And she played rook c7. And she only make a draw. After she is complicated. You see that you lose your chance, then things are going, can go badly. Because white made only a draw. She didn't took the full point, which was not very difficult. But she missed one move, sorry. Here I like also a lot this driving, an old game played in 1964. So old that it was played before I even born, can you imagine? So white here has some kind of attack, but his queen on g6 is hanging, yeah? Well, actually, how was the position? The position was like this. And black was happy, very happy. He was telling, okay, I have very good defense. I'm not in danger of anything. I will win later. And white played queen takes g6. Wow. Okay, black cannot take with the pawn is forbidden. He has to take the queen, otherwise he will be a piece down. So what? Driving.
Bishop g7.
And driving. Okay, from this combination, white won only one pawn. Don't expect that you're gonna win everything in your life. It's not easy. Pawn is a pawn. But the most funny stuff is that after a lot of moves, white is winning. Yeah, no problem. He made another driving here. He played check. And after check, and he won another pawn. So it's a very nice game, very interesting, where white used the idea of the driving two times. You cannot see it every day.
Coach.
So, here comes a very the usual stuff. Well, this one you can find it as a combination in a lot of books. But here white used our idea of driving to kill the position. First of all, rook takes bishop. Why he does this? Because he wants that the black rook doesn't protect anymore this pawn. So the rook is drawn to square, which is not important now for black. And now check, double attack. You have to take. And check, wins the house. So drive the rook away. Drive the queen to ideal square. The king is already in the ideal square, over. So I will stop here. We have three, maybe three, four more, but Mr. Coach Marlon wants to deal with you because he wants to teach you as well. I think all this we see today with one combination is how also we work in the next lessons. We take a subject and we work in the subject until you learn it. Very important that you learn it. So what means I learn it? It means that I can make it in my game. So, thanks for coming. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you tomorrow, huh? Everybody comes. Okay?
Bye, sir.